Hello everyone, Joshua Myers here, and welcome back to my 31 Days of October review series. And today we're going to be looking at the film Hatchet from 2007.
Once upon a time, there was a boy named Victor Crowley. Folks weren't too kind of Victor, so he stayed hidden in his daddy's house, out in the bayou. One night, some mean children came to his house, and there was a bad fire. When his daddy chopped down the door to save him, he didn't know Victor was pressed against the other side. And poor Victor Crowley died. They say people disappear in those woods. And legend has it, if you get close enough to the old Crowley house at night, you can still hear Victor Crowley roaming in the woods, crying for his daddy.
I want to go home. We're all gonna die.
It stars Robert Englund, Tony Todd, Kane Hodder, and is directed by Adam Green. The plot of Hatchet is that a group of tourists embark on a boat ride of the haunted Louisiana bayous, where they learn the terrifying tale of a local legend, Victor Crowley, portrayed by Kane Hodder, a horribly disfigured man who was tragically and accidentally killed with a hatchet by the hands of his own father. But when the boat sinks and the ghost story turns out to be real, the group tries desperately to escape the swamp with their lives and all of their pieces. What did I like about Hatchet? Honestly, for me, I liked everything about Hatchet. Like, it was a genuine surprise. And this was my first time watching Hatchet. I've heard about it. The first time I've heard about it was through the Dead Pit radio show back in the day. I gotta say, it's a really awesome movie. I do like that it's not only a throwback to the classic 80s slasher films, but I also like the fact it kind of makes fun of some of those stuff, like especially with the classic 80s slasher tropes and cliches. I really like that it did that. And I did like the characters of Marcus, portrayed by Dion Richmond, and I also like the character of Mary Beth, portrayed Tamara Feldman. I really did like those two. Character Ben, not so much, and the other characters, they were pretty disposable. But overall, I really liked the characters of Mary Beth and Marcus. I thought those two were really good characters. Marcus was especially hilarious in it. I also thought it was cool to see, to basically see the three big horror icons like Robert Englund, Kane Hodder, Tony Todd, three of the big horror icons in one movie. That's really nice to see. Also, I think Adam Green is an amazing director and writer. I really liked what he did with this movie. Not only that, I also did like the musical score too. Like, it's actually a score, not just for the music they throw in from other artists, but I mainly also like the music that was composed for this movie. In fact, it's so good, I'm honestly thinking about picking up a soundtrack to Hatchet, if they even have one. If they have a soundtrack to Hatchet, let me know in the comments below. Because if so, I'm definitely getting it. Also, I did like the killer, Victor Crowley, portrayed by Kane Hodder. I just overall liked the character, and I did like the backstory of the character and everything. And honestly, I think Kane Hodder's Victor Crowley is an underrated horror icon. And I think it's an icon of horror that should be talked about more. I also did like the cinematography in this. It's shot beautifully. Also, here's the thing. I'm not normally for gore, but if you're going to go for gore, go all the way with it. Have fun with it. And that's what this movie does, actually. There's a lot of gore, Which, by the way, all of it is practical effects and really dang good practical effects, mind ya. The death scene were awesome. I'm not going to lie, the death scenes were amazing. And knowing that the pacing of this movie is really good too. I mean, the movie's about an hour and 30 minutes, but when you're watching it, it doesn't feel like you're watching an hour and 30 minutes of a movie. Not at all. Like, it goes by pretty quickly, while at the same time still putting out a really good quality product. What did I not like about it? Honestly, for me, there's nothing I didn't like about this movie, actually. This movie, in my mind, is flawless, which is a first to say about any movie that came out in the 2000s and 2010 era, especially when it regards to horror films. And with that said, I'm going to give Hatchet from 2007 a 5 out of 5 stars. This was a genuine surprise of a movie. I mean, me and Amanda watched this recently, and she agrees with everything I've said here, actually. She loved the hell out of it, the movie. And we thought it was a genuine surprise. We didn't thought it was going to be that good, at least to that extent. In fact, we loved it so much, we decided to watch Hatchet 2 through Amazon Prime. And you're going to be seeing my review of that pretty soon. I'm going to be filming that after this review. So that's it for this review. Thank you guys for watching, and see you next time.